This is GBC Web TV, on the internet at gbcweb.tv. Welcome to Greenford Baptist Church in West London. Here you can enjoy inspired biblical teaching. You can visit gbcweb.tv on the internet, watch a range of Christian videos, and download them as audio podcasts to your MP3 player or PC, or order video DVDs and audio CDs for personal or church use. He Delights in You, Psalm 37, verse 23, by Rotimi Awoniyi.
And God is going to move you. God is going to walk with you because He delights in walking with you. He delights in the progress that you are making. He delights in the life that you are living. He delights because He wants you to be where He wants you to be. My name is Rotimi Awoniyi. I'm a member of Greenford Baptist Church. And I'm going to read for us from Psalm 37, verse 23. Psalm 37, verse 23. And I'm going to be using reading from the New Living Translation. 37:23. The steps of the godly are directed by the Lord. He delights in every detail of their lives. The steps of the godly are directed by the Lord. Of the lives. The steps, your steps, are directed by the Lord. And He, that is our God, our Lord, delights in every detail of my life, in every detail of your life. This morning, I'm going to be talking to us briefly about this. But before we start, I'd like us to pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You for this morning. We thank You for the opportunity that we have to be in Your presence. We thank You for Your goodness. We thank You for Your grace. We thank You for Your blessings. We thank You for the things that You do for us day by day. Even when sometimes we walk away from You, You are there for us, calling us back, urging us to come back to You. So, Father, we thank You for that. And we pray that as You speak to us this morning, as You minister to us this morning, we pray that Your blessings will overtake us. We pray that Your words will fall on fertile grounds here this morning. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you will touch each and every one of us. You meet us at our very point of need. Heavenly Father, we pray that by the time we finish this morning, we will have encountered You in a very, very special way. As we pray in Jesus' precious name. Amen. The steps of the godly are directed by the Lord. He delights in every details of their lives. The steps of Timmy, the steps of Angel, the steps of Jeeves, they are directed by the Lord. And He delights in every detail of our lives. Not just those three people that I mentioned, but each and every one of us, God delights in the details of our lives. And for those that have small children, we look at them as they grow up. We fancy, we enjoy, we are proud as parents when we see our child move, take the first step. I know that some parents will have video recorder ready for that first step, because they want to capture it for posterity. When our child goes from nursery school to primary school, I know my wife wants to be there on the very day the child goes to primary school. When she's not able to go there, she commandeers me to go there. When they finish in primary school, she wants to be there on the very last day. She enjoys the fact that her child is moving from primary school into secondary school, and I can assure you that when it's time to go to university, she'll be there enjoying the fact that my son is going to secondary school, is going to university. And in the same way, God delights in our progress. God wants to see us make progress. And I want you to know this morning that life is a journey. We can never, ever overemphasize that life is a journey. And you go step by step, step by step. You cannot run until you've started to walk. It's step by step. However good or bad life is, it is still a journey. And our steps are ordered by the Lord. And His purpose is to take us step by step to where He wants to take us. The thing is, the fact of life is this. For every one of us, we have to move from the position of immaturity to position of maturity. Just as a child moves from the position of immaturity to maturity, it is a step, it is a process to go through. And it is a process as children of God that we go through to reach that position of maturity, to reach that position where God is asking us to be. Whatever it is in life, wherever it is in life, whatever your ministry, whatever your position, whatever you do, you have to move from position, from one step to other. It's a process. And I believe that Richard will join me in saying that he's an accountant as myself. You cannot just wake up one morning and say, I am an accountant. You have to go through a process. You have to learn the trade. And learning the trade does not mean that you know the trade. You have to gain experience before they let you loose on innocent clients. It is a process. And the same thing, if you're a medical doctor, if you're a nurse, you have to go through the process. You have to be trained, and you housemanship or whatever they call it. You follow a professor around the patients. They ask you questions. And then you move on. So it is with Christian life. So it is with Christian life. But God delights as we move, as we take those steps, as we move step by step by step. He delights in every details of our lives. The thing about moving in God is that it is not just movement. It is not movement. Because you can move, you can make movement for 40 years and end up not actually being where God wants you to be. So what we are talking about here this morning is about moving in God's purpose, moving in God's channel, moving into where God wants you to be. It's going to be sad that you've been a Christian so many years. And then at the end of the day, you find that you've only just been making movement, but not actually connected to God's purpose for your life. It is not enough to move. have to move towards God's purpose. Movement is not progress. Movement is not progress. But progressing step by step towards God's goal for you, towards goal, God's objective for you, that is progress. And when you make progress, you have fulfillment. So actually, in all cases, what we call fulfillment is sometimes referred to as success. As you move, there will be times that there will be difficulties. I'm not cursing. I'm just stating the fact. There will be top of the mountains situations, positions, and there will be down the valley days. But if you are walking with God, if you are moving in his purpose for you, if you are taking that step as he has ordained for you, if you are moving in his purpose, I tell you, it will help you. It will push you through those valley moments. We are human. We will sleep. Yes, we will sleep. But God is with us. It is a slippery road. It is a slippery journey. But God is with us. God is walking beside us. God is walking alongside us. God is holding our hands. There was a day I prayed for someone, and I've never been to this person's house before. And as I was praying, I said, God is saying that there will be times when you got to let yourself go, and I will carry you from one position to the other. And after we prayed, she said, have you been to my house before? I said, I've never been to your house before. And she said, in my living room, there's this big picture where there's you see steps, and then you don't see steps, and then you see steps again. And the picture was depicting that when things become difficult, God was holding them up until they're able to walk on their own again. So as you go through life, as you go through difficulties, as you go through those valley moments, God is able to move and to lift you up and take you to the next level. God enjoys the progress we make. He delights in seeing that although we are not where we want to be, we are not where we used to be. Do you get that? He delights in the fact that although we are not where he wants us to be, which is point B, but we are not where we used to be, which is point A. We are on the journey. We should delight in where we are. We should delight. Many years back, actually, I'm not sure it's that many years. I said I would like to see one day when we will be seeking planning permission from the council to see this place transformed, have people sit round at the top, because we cannot accommodate people on this ground floor. That is my vision. I don't know if you share it with me, but that is what we want to see. We want to see the Greenford, we want to see Northwood come to know God. And until we start to move in God's purpose for us, until we start to claim ground for him, until we start to soak this area with his power and his authority, we are not going to see that achieved. We need to move step by step, step by step. And we need to be following his purpose for us. And the thing is this, my God is not a static God. My God is a dynamic God. I don't know about you. The God that you worship is not a God that stands still. It's not a God that says, I want to be here permanently, I don't want to move. This is my place. The God that we worship is a God that moves every time. Remember the children of Israel, when he was taking them out of Egypt to the promised land. He was there with them, moving day by day, and he's here with us, moving with us. Our God is a dynamic God. It's not a static God. And he doesn't want his children to be static. He doesn't want his children to be rooted, to be doing the same thing day in, day out. He wants you to move with him. He wants you to be where he wants you to be. And unless and until we catch hold of that, we will just be making movement. We will just be making movement. Keep moving, as God is not static. Keep moving, as God is with you. But the thing is, as you move in God's purpose, Satan seeks to destroy you, your calling, even in his infancy. David had talked to us about David. We spent, you know, David, about David in the Bible. We spent a lot of time talking about David, I think earlier this year. And even before he himself realized God's calling on his life, Satan had begun to move. And as you start to take step in God's path, Satan will start to move. We are just learning about Moses. Even in his babyish period, Satan was beginning to move. So as we begin to be in God's, as we begin to connect to God, as we begin to be in God's root for us, Satan will start to move. Satan will want to say, look, let me tell you something, which is a fact. When we are not in God's radar, Satan is not bothered. It's not bothered. But the moment you say, I believe my Redeemer liveth, he wakes up and thinks, no, that cannot be. I need to do something about this one. So we have to be on our guard. But I just want to affirm this. God is not only able, he is abundantly able to stand with you and walk with you, to walk alongside you and move you to where he wants you to be. And that brings me to the second part of my talk this morning. Joseph, he had a calling on his life. He had a calling on his life. He was born just like you were born, just like I was born. But right from that tender age, God marked his life. And he had a dream. He dreamt of where God was taking him. Where God, what God had in store for him. God has a lot in store for you. And you bet you need to catch hold of it. You don't need someone telling you this is what God wants you to do. When Jesus died on the cross, remember the curtain of the temple was torn into two. giving you and giving me the opportunity to go straight to God, to relate straight with God, to connect straight with God. It's like electricity. When you plug it in, boom, you are there. When things are going swimmingly well, it's with me. When they are going the other way, it's there with me, present with me. But I want you to know that when we move, God delights in everything that we do. I remember when Babolu, that's my dad, I call him Babolu. That's Papa Olu, that's Olu is me. So I call him my papa, if you understand. He came here, I think, 2005, for 6 months, just to rest. And we talked over the phone before then. We would talk, and he would ask questions, we would answer questions. And I think 2 days after they re-arrived with my mom, they sat myself and Ola down, started asking questions. What have you done here? What have you done there? What is this? What is that? A parent delights in the way that the child is progressing. A parent wants to know what the child is doing. A parent delights in knowing that my child is not just marking time for today, but is planning for tomorrow, is planning for the day after, is planning for the day after that. So we go back to, he dreamt, Joseph dreamt of where God was taking him, what God had in store for him. And guess what? Satan moved quickly. He moved, as he moved in David's life, as he moved in Moses' life, as he moved even in Jesus' life. He moved. And he moved through a process. I'm not going to go through the whole history of Joseph, how he started and where he is. We'll be talking about a section of his life. He moved and through a process which I believe you are familiar with, he was sold to Ishmaelites, who then sold him to an Egyptian. But listen to this. God is good. And all the time. I'm going to read from Genesis verse 39. Chapter 39, verse 2. I'm not using the church Bible, so I can't give you the page. Chapter 39, verse 2. Page 43. The Lord was with Joseph, and he prospered, and he lived in the house of his Egyptian master. God is good. This is a slave. He had been sold on. Actually, I think this is the second time he was sold. He was sold by his brothers to the Ishmaelites, and then the Ishmaelites to the Egyptian. But God with him, and he prospered. God had already anointed him. God had already proposed something for his life. And God is going to say, nothing is going to make you go away from me. I'm going to walk with you. I'm going to stand with you. I'm going to make you be what you want you to be. When we were worshiping this morning, the song that Lucy sang, Faithful One, So Unchanging. Our God is a faithful God. Our God is a faithful God. And I thought, let me see if I can get it on the screen. Faithful One, So Unchanging. Ageless One, You are my rock of peace. Lord of all, I depend on you. I call out to you again and again. I call out to you again and again. You are my rock in times of trouble. You lift me up when I fall down. He is with us. Joseph found favor. He found favor. But Satan never gives up. He never gives up. He was lurking in the corner and caused his master's wife to cause him problem. But I tell you something. I tell you here this morning, God's anointing is upon our lives. God's anointing is upon our lives. He has called us to be His. He has called us to be His children. Whatever Satan, whatever the powers and principalities, whatever the world may be throwing against us, I tell you, they will not stand. But we have to connect continuously with our Lord and with our God. We have to connect. We have to, like the electricity, we have to be plugged in. God's business is not a Sunday business. I remember when I was young, there's a medication we used to take every Sunday. Sunday medication. God's business is not a Sunday business. It's every day. Every day, 24 hours, every second, we have to be connected to Him. We have to be saying, Lord, I am here. I am walking with you. And I want you to walk with me. And I want you to deal with me. And I want you to change me when I need changing. I want you to move me when I need moving. Satan's operandi, modus operandi, it's not different. It's the same through generations. Remember in the Garden of Eden, God built that beautiful garden and put first man and first woman there. Satan was not happy. Before they could actually achieve anything, he intervened. And through generation, that's the process. But I tell you this morning, God is Satan is a liar. Satan is a liar. He will not be able to touch you. He will not be able to destroy you. He will not be able to destroy God's plan in your life. There will be problems. Joseph had problems. So his master's wife said, "You are so beautiful. You are handsome. I've never seen anything like this. I need you to come to bed with me." And being the person that he was, he refused. He was thrown into jail. But I tell you something, he moved from being a prisoner in one day to being prime minister the same day. That is how God can move. He moved from being a prisoner in one day to being a prime minister in one day. Let's read it. Let's read. Verse 41, chapter 41. Chapter 41. Verse 41. This is a person that is just coming out of prison. Pharaoh had called him. While he was in prison, he had helped interpret some people's dreams, and it had come to pass. And Pharaoh had dreams. And he looked far and wide to see who was going to interpret the dreams for him. And one of the servants that Joseph helped said, "Oh, I remember. I ask for forgiveness today. And Heavenly Father, this morning, if there's anything that is anyone or anything that is standing in your way, if there's anything that is stopping you from being where God wants you to be, we stand against those things this morning. Together, we are breaking those barriers this morning. Together, we are saying to those things, they have no position in your life. And he says, so Pharaoh said to Joseph, I hereby put you in charge of the whole land of Egypt. Then Pharaoh took his signet from his finger and put it on Joseph's finger. He dressed him in robes of fine linen and put a gold chain around his neck. He had him ride in a chariot as his second in command. And men shouted before him, make way. Thus, he put him in charge of the whole land of Egypt. Then Pharaoh said to Joseph, I am Pharaoh, but without your word, no one will lift hand or foot in all Egypt. Wow. God is at work. When our God moves, he moves far powerfully. God is at work. Joseph went from being a prisoner, forgotten in prison, to being the prime minister, answerable only to God and to Pharaoh. That is one massive promotion. That is one massive promotion. And this morning, it may be that you're thinking, in my ministry, in my life, what is it that God is purpose for? What is God's purpose for me? And I tell you, here this morning, I can tell you that God's purpose for you is there with you. We cannot expect God to move if we are not connected to him. That's why I said God's purpose for you is there with you, because you've got to be connected for him to be able to move. When the time is right, God will move. And I know that God will move for you. I tell you, my flabber is just gasted. From prison to prisoner. In modern history, I think the person that we can say had something similar to that is Mandela. But even then, Mandela had to wait months. He had to campaign to become president. We are talking same day. There's a section that says, when they brought him out, they had to shave. He had to have his bath and he had to change his clothing. Wow. And I pray this morning, you are going to experience God's promotion in your ministry. You are going to experience God's promotion in your life. You are going to experience God's promotion in everything that you lay your hands upon. But brothers and sisters, we got to be connected. Remember, he delights in our steps, in everything that we do, in every way that we go. He delights in it. He wants us to succeed. He wants us to be at point B that he wants us to be. But we need to be in his presence. He enjoys being our father. I sit down sometimes and I look at my girls and my boys and I just smile to myself. How much more you that he sent his precious son to come down and die for? He laid down his son so that you and I can be connected to him, so that we can claim salvation, so that we can be partakers in the kingdom of God. If I, ordinary Rotimi Awoniyi, can look at my children and just feel just a sense of happiness, a sense of joy, how much more our Lord and our God? Joseph remained steadfast. My mom would say, when you are with God, you don't mix white with black. For those that understand Yoruba, she will say, "Akinda dudumo funfun." You don't mix white with black. If you are going to stay connected, stay with God. There's opportunity in life for us to get distracted. Every day, everywhere we go, there's opportunity. But we got to stay connected to him. Don't mix white with black. They are not compatible at all. And my father-in-law wrote a card, I think birthday card, for one of his children. And he wrote, "Thank you for your stickability." Essentially, what he was trying to communicate was, this is one child that has stood with me, that has worked with me, that has done everything with me. When I'm happy, she was there. When I'm not happy, it's not all her, by the way. When I'm not happy, she was there. Every time she was there with me. Thank you for your stickability. And it's the same thing God is wanting of us here. He wants to stick with him. He wants us to walk with him. He wants us to live with him. He wants us to sleep with him. He wants us to everything with him. It's not a case of menu. You know, you go to a restaurant that's buffet or whatever, and they give you menu and you pick the bits that you want. We cannot serve God and serve what? Mammon. We've got to serve him alone. That's no option. Is God. Joseph remained steadfast to God's calling. We have to remain steadfast. And this morning I want to tell you, I want to let you into a secret. It's a massive secret. Do you know that you carry a precious cargo? Do you know that? Do you know you carry a special cargo? Yes. Very, very precious. The Spirit of God. You carry a special cargo. And tell me something. It's possible I'm wrong here. It's possible I'm wrong here. Is there any power, any authority, mighty enough to sink that cargo? So why is it that as children of God, we act like we don't have anything? Why is it that as children of God, we act like we are powerless? Why is it that we are not taking our possessions and we are not claiming what belongs to us? You are precious because you carry special anointing, because you carry a special and a precious cargo in you. When you go, He is with you. Every time, every day, every moment, He's walking with you. Satan cannot damage it. Satan cannot sink it. Satan cannot destroy it. Satan cannot move it. Then why do we get scared of him, of Satan? Why don't we speak words of authority against Satan? Why don't we claim what belongs to us? Why don't we do what God wants us to do? I tell you this morning, the cargo you carry in you is precious. And God is going to move you. God is going to walk with you because He delights in walking with you. He delights in the progress that you are making. He delights in the life that you are living. He delights because He wants you to be where He wants you to be. This morning, I'm saying to you, nobody and nothing can stop you. Nothing can derail you. Only if you remain connected to Him. Only if you remain connected to Him. Joseph, God's calling on his life was permanent, was there, and he lived to serve God. Even when his brother sold him, he still found favor with God. And as he found favor with God, people that he came into contact with gave him favor. And that's going to be your experience today. That's going to be your experience because God's favor is upon you. His spirit is upon you. His spirit is upon you. But you need to be connected. This morning, I just want to, before we finish, just want to quickly say, the steps of the godly are directed by the Lord. He delights in every details of their lives. And this morning, only if you are going to claim it, only if you are going to take hold of that, only if you are going to say to yourself, that statement is for me. I don't know about you, but it is for me. I don't know if you are going to take possession of it, but definitely it is for Rotimi Awoniyi this morning. I know life is a journey. I know life will have the bad and the good moments. I know there will be the down the valley moments. I know there will be top of the mountain moments. But God is with me. God is working with me. When I'm down in the valley, and I call unto my Lord, God is going to move powerfully for my purpose. God is going to move and bring me to the other side. Because this morning I am telling you, my brothers and sisters, that we need to start to take possession of what God is asking of us. We need to start to claim grants. We need to see God's kingdom move in our lives. We need to see God's power move in our lives. We need to see Him in everything that we do. He delights in every details of our lives. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this morning. We thank you for the words that you have spoken to us. Heavenly Father, we just want to commit each and every one of us into your hand, Lord. We just pray, Lord God, that you just take hold of us and you start to move us where you want to move us. You start to change us how you want to change us. You start to take us where you want to take us. We pray that your spirit, your anointing will be upon each of your children here this morning. Father, we thank you. And I pray, Heavenly Father, that if there's anything that is stopping your children from taking hold of what you have ordained for them, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you break hold of those things in Jesus' name. We pray, Heavenly Father, that your children will know your goodness, that your children will know your anointing, that your children will know your power moving their lives, Lord. Father, we just thank you and we glorify your holy name as we pray in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Amen.
We do hope you've enjoyed and benefited from this presentation. To learn more about what the Bible teaches us and how to apply this to our everyday lives, check out our biblical teaching and other videos at gbcweb.tv.